In India, bathing is considered more like a ritual than a routine. If carried out properly, bath energizes the body, relaxes the mind, eliminates fatigue, sweat, dirt, and environmental toxins from the skin. However, the sad part is that almost 99% of the people bath in a wrong way, due to which they are unintentionally harming their body rather than getting its benefits. You may feel fresh after a bath, but your body might be suffering it. Bathing when done in a wrong way becomes the reason for dark circles, hair fall, rough skin, weak immunity, weak digestion, lethargy, and even serious health issues. So if you want to know the right way of bathing, stay tuned. Hello friends, welcome to Fit Tuber. Bathing has always been accorded the status of a sacred activity in India, although it does not mean that we can take bath in whatever way we want to. In this video, I will share with you 6 reasons you are bathing the wrong way and the ways to fix it. Watching this video till the end, you will have a clear idea as to when, how, and how many times you should bathe so that it heals your body and not harms it. Number 6, bathing with hot water. This may be a shocker for some of you, but according to Ayurveda, no matter what season it is, a healthy person should never use hot water for bathing. Always take cold water bath. And when I say cold water, I do not mean ice cold water, but the normal running tap water. Hot water bath does not even heighten your senses, but instead it makes you lethargic. Hot water bath may also become the reason for increased dark circles, weak digestion, low immunity, and stress. More so, pouring hot water over head is seriously damaging for hair, head, and eyes. Doing so, you are bound to face excessive hair fall and even serious health ailments. Only in certain health conditions like arthritis, hot water can be used. Although if you are not able to get over this habit of hot water bathing, then at least switch to mild lukewarm water. But in any case, pouring hot or warm water on the head and eyes is a strict no-no. Now even the direction in which you take bath makes a difference. If you are using cold water, then pour water from head to toe. While if you are using lukewarm water, then wash yourself from down to up. No, it is not a superstition, but it maintains proper blood flow, avoiding any possibility of a blood clot. So try to switch to cold bath, as it is the best way to energize your body early in the morning. Number 5, bathing after meals. Experiment on your body. On 2 different days, take bath at the same time of the day. On day 1, eat before your bath. On day 2, eat after your bath. Observe how your body responds. Whether you feel any difference in terms of hunger and digestion, most likely you will feel better in the latter scenario. This is because the process of digestion consumes a lot of energy and requires plenty of blood flow towards the stomach. But when you take bath right after a meal, the body temperature decreases. Now to maintain the temperature of the skin, even the blood from the stomach is transported to the skin. As a result, your digestion process slows down, your intestines becomes weaker, and you end up suffering from constipation and other stomach related issues. Avoid bathing after eating, as it will definitely cause digestive issues. If at all you want to have a bath after eating, make sure to keep a gap of at least 2 hours. Number 4, not oil massaging before bath. Oil massage before a bath is one of the hidden secrets of effective bath. When we massage our body with oil, it easily attracts the microorganisms and toxins off the surface and removes them successfully. No wonder that traditionally in India, bath never started with water. It always ended with it. A lot of stress has been given on the effectiveness of this practice in the classical Ayurvedic texts. However, considering our modern busy lifestyles, it might not be very practical to carry this out on a daily basis. Although I would suggest you to do it at least once a week, maybe on Sundays. Personally, I do it almost every day. Trust me, it's not that difficult. Even spending just 2 minutes before bath will serve the purpose, and you will end up having a clearer and softer skin. You can use coconut oil, mustard oil, or sesame oil for this. Number 3, not removing the dead skin. Are you effectively removing the dead skin? Probably not. Even after washing and cleansing, there are many dead skin cells that even the best of the soaps miss out on. There are 2 important things that you should do. Firstly, use a scrubber. I personally use a natural scrubber. Not only it is biodegradable and eco-friendly, but also is much cheaper than the plastic loofah. It is super easy to use as well. Just put soap on the body first, wet the loofah, remove the extra water from it, then scrub your skin with it. Using it regularly increases the blood circulation and unclogs the skin pores. Another mistake that many people make is that after bathing, they very gently dry out the body with towel. Actually, towel should be rubbed with slight pressure along the surface of the whole body. Doing these 2 things will remove the dead skin layer, helping the new cells to come up. up. Number 2, wrong duration of bathing. How much time do you spend bathing? Are you the one who enters the bathroom, opens the shower for a while, hurriedly applies the soap, washes off, and comes out running? Or you are one of those who spends hours in the bathroom, continuously splashing water over the body? Ideally, you should not fall into any of these categories. Bathing is not just meant to cleanse the physical body, but also rejuvenate the mind and soul. It should be carried out calmly, purposefully. It is only then you can reap the benefits out of it. Ancient texts even suggest to practice deep breathing while bathing. Although this does not mean that we spend too much time in bathroom, pouring too much water or applying excess soap will eventually dry out the skin, making it rough. Even bathing too many times in a day is not recommended. To bathe every day is compulsory. Once in the morning is ideal. Last but definitely not the least, the number one reason you are bathing the wrong way is that you are using toxic products. Which bathing soap, shower gel, body wash, or shampoo do you use? Have you ever gone through the ingredient list of the products that you use while bathing? You will be shocked to know that over 95% of the products in the Indian market have harsh chemicals like mineral oil, sulfates, parabens, harsh alcohols, silicones, artificial fragrances, colors, which do more harm than good. Because we use these products on a daily basis, slowly their ingredients seep into our bloodstream, causing rough skin, hair fall, dandruff, allergies, and sometimes deadly diseases. So make it a point to always go through the ingredient list of the products that you wish to buy and choose the products which are 100% natural. Just this one habit can bring a huge relief to your skin and hair issues. Bathing is energizing, it is healing and purifying. All you need to do is take it the right way. If you are looking for toxin-free natural products in the Indian market, allow me to introduce to you a refreshing range of Arata products who have been kind enough to partner with us for this video. A moisturizing body wash, a refreshing face wash, a nourishing hair cream, a zero damage hair gel, all 100% natural shampoo, and a smooth lip balm. Arata products are made with ingredients which are completely plant sourced, organic, non-GMO, and safe for both men and women. Arata is PETA certified Indian company which uses absolutely no toxic chemicals in their products. All these products by Arata are suitable for all skin types. Arata products are natural in true sense, and what makes them better is that they have not compromised on their performance. They do not even charge any shipping cost. More so, Arata is giving a discount of 30% if you buy their whole bundle and 20% off for any order, especially for the FitTuber community. Just apply the coupon code FT20. So buy Arata products by clicking on the link down in the description box. So friends, that's all for this video. I hope you found it to be helpful. If yes, then please show me your support by giving this video a big thumbs up. What should be the next video in this series? Let me know in the comments below. Please do remember to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so that you never miss a video from me. My name is Vivek. I thank you so much for watching.